I want to be a historian.
I want to be a marine scientist.
I want to be an oceanographer.
I want to be an astronaut.
I want to be a zoologist.
I want to be an engineer.
Virginia is rich in educational resources.
Virginia is for.
Virginia is for.
Virginia is for.
Virginia is for.
Virginia's for learners!
Please, you can get seated so we can get started. Ladies and gentlemen, get your attention, please, while the guys are getting seated. We've got a special recognition this evening. We have brought Dennis Katufis, Coach K, all the way from Charleston, South Carolina. Give it up. Coach K was here from 84 to 96, and we will talk about some of the successes here in a second, but I do want to point out, if any of you ever wondered or thought about what an impact looks like as a coach or an adult in education, look at that crowd over there. Coach K and Denbigh would also win two of the prestigious Peninsula District Tournament Championships. That was from 86 and 89. And as well, if you guys remember, the 85 and 88 famed Fort Eustis Christmas Tournament. He won two of those. Our 1986 team would go on to beat Indian River, led by NBA Hall of Famer Alonzo Mourning, and Kempska, led by the number one ranked player in the nation at the time, J.R. Reed, back-to-back in the regionals. play Hampton tonight, I got another point to make. The 89 team would beat the eventual state champion Crabbers twice during that season. And the 89 team would go on to win the district tournament title as well. And Coach would go on to lead us through the 1996 season. He finished with a career record of 178 and 108. And he would then be named the head coach at the newly opened Heritage High School in 1996. And he would lead the Hurricanes to the Peninsula District regular season title in 2003 and the Peninsula District tournament titles in 03 and 04. And he led Heritage to the state tournament in 2000, 2002, and 2003. We got our own Coach K. I would be remiss if I didn't mention that he did finish at Mitchville in 2014. That's all that I could dig up from that era. His tenure has seen him lead future school leaders, business owners, military leaders, and community leaders. Coach, we thank you for your dedication to your players. Can you come out to midcourt, please? Marcus. As a token of our appreciation, thank you for standing up. We have a basketball that's been signed by all of your alumni here tonight for you to take back to Charleston. We're not done, Coach. Hey, Coach Jay Grimes from the current squad would like to say something.
Normally, I don't get on microphones. I just stay in my little box here in the corner, so this is very new for me. But I want to take this moment to thank everybody, all of the alumni that have came out tonight. This is a very big moment for our program, for Coach K, of course. He is an amazing man, an amazing mentor. He has been everything to this program, and I am very grateful to have you guys here. I'm proud that my guys are able to display their talents tonight for you. I want to make a promise to you guys that we're going to restore Denbigh to where it was, and we're going to bring back that pride. I'm not going to make any big promises about results. We're going to go up here, line up every day, and we're going to get better every day. And we're going to make sure that we put a product on the floor that you guys believe, and that you guys trust, and that you guys can rely, that we're going to work every day to get better. From the men's basketball team, our captains. We'd like to present this jersey to you, Coach K. I'm not sure what year this jersey was, but it was the oldest jersey that I could find in the closet, and I think that you should have it. And if this is somebody's number in the stands, then you're being recognized as well tonight. My last token of appreciation is I've made some postcards for all of you guys that have came back. It has another picture of our team. It also has some words for you guys as well. So I'll give that to Lee. Please make sure you grab one of these postcards as an appreciation from our team. Thank you so much, guys.
Hey, guys, enjoy yourselves tonight. Let's cheer the guys on. Thanks, Coach. Don't let me forget, I say all day. Coach Anderson came all the way from Houston. Coach, thank you. We love you. He was a part of all those teams also.
JV coach. I knew we had talent to win here. And I would be remiss to say the great players, I can't name them all, but the coaches that I had, Maxie, forever. I see Leon Wood, John Harbell, and Ben Moore got a start. I'm telling you, Ben Moore got a start. Who am I missing? Help me, help me. Oh, Frazier and Chris Moore's here? Chris Moore, stand up. I owe your dad so much. So thank you. Alright, thank you so much for being here. And I had a little thing going that I would like to start for these guys. My last years at Midfield and at Heritage, I started getting friends to sponsor players to go to camp. And that does so much for these kids to get out of Newport News and away to camp. So maybe then some people here will get in contact with you. And it's not, you know, we could do that in a heartbeat and sponsor 10 kids to go to camp or whatever. So that's just the thought. And for the Denbigh players, if you have to understand one thing. If you've got a will, then there'll be a way to get a championship. If you have the will, there'll be a way. All right, thank you very much.
Start back for another 10 minutes. Maybe later.
If we can get him in before the game starts.
Ray and I talked about during.
What do I want to drink? Let's see.
I think I'll get a water. Give me all the nutrients I need.
Whoa, man, you just hit my car.
Chill out, man. I didn't even hit your car.
I'll show you chill out.
That was a bit of an overreaction. In order to manage your anger better and make sure events like this don't happen to you, here are a few small pieces of advice that you can follow. Think before acting. Take deep breaths.